Hello, everybody. Oops, I'm gonna lock this camera on me for now. Hi, everybody. Hey, I'm. Hi, comrades. This is I am Commander Grizzly here. Well, guys, right now, as you probably would have guessed, I am not aboard the ship, for that matter. In fact, I am being held captive by my superiors. And until such time, I'm hoping Jack will be able to handle the crew. Then we'll continue on where I started. But for now, I have to finish what I started months ago by finishing the reactions to Resident Evil, guys. But thing is, for me, I'm not alone. And so I have there's a reviewer who hates this series as much as I do. So yeah, I'm gonna continue to react to this. I'm gonna finish this series up. It's time we finish up this series once and for all. Today's reaction is gonna be the tube Retribution. And I mentioned it before on Twitter that I would be reacting to this, but I never got to, so this is my chance to get to it, everyone. Might as well, since I'm trapped, and this place is just a hologram. The people who are behind me are just simulations. So I might as well get to it. So, yeah. This is going to be a two-parter, so the second part will have to be tomorrow. By the way, guys, before I get started, I own the movie. I own this movie. Once again, guys, I'm going to tell you guys I own this movie and any of the songs that come out with that. So, once again, it's a warning that anyone that claims my videos, says claim my videos, or says hate talking in my video, your channel, I'll have YouTube terminate your channel effective immediately. So, please do not forget this warning. That said, I'm going to get started on this reaction. 3, 2, 1, and go.
What? What is this? Ah, crap. Either I just moved to Raccoon City, or it's Resident Evil time again.
Apocalypse. Well, here we go. Retribution. Yep, this is what I think when I think of this movie.
You know, I've been dressing this way for all these Resident Evil reviews, and this is the first time Barry will actually be in what I'm reviewing. Barry celebration time!
Yep.
What the hell? What is it? What the hell is this place anyway?
The Jibble Sandwich.
You're right.
What? What is this?
Stand back!
Go, Barry.
A close one. What?
A second late. You would have fit nicely into a sandwich.
You're right.
The Jibble Sandwich. Jill, have you found anything interesting?
What is it?
Blood. Hope this is not Chris's blood.
Oh, yeah, Jill, Resident Evil.
Here's a lockpick. It might be handy if you, the master of unlocking, take it with you.
You're right.
It might be handy if you, the master of sandwiches, take it with you.
Barry.
Just take a look at this. It's...
Alright, before I continue, guys, what's being shown here, there is one of the famous characters of the Resident Evil games, Barry Allen. He is one of the original cast of the Resident Evil. He is from the first Resident Evil game. And I believe he was also in the Resident Evil 5 and I believe Resident Evil 3, I think. Other than that, I think this is but what we're about to find out is that he is not the character that we in this movie that he is that the so-called character is in. He's just a side character, just like everybody else. So just fair warning, everyone.
Forest. Oh my god, blood. Hope this is not
not Enrico's blood,
yeah? I don't know what's going on.
You're almost a jewel,
Sandwich. Barry, you're so optimistic.
It looks like a crow made our forest. Sandwich, now Wesker, Sandwich.
What?
I'll stay here and secure our escape route.
Barry!
I have this.
Oh, yeah. I'll take you down, Wesker. Hey, Burton. Barry Burton.
And of course, the Barry in this film only has the look and name of the actual Barry. He has none of the backstory or character, and no, he does not mention a sandwich once.
I hate you, Retribution.
Shit. So when I first seen promo pictures for this movie, I was like,
what is this?
Then when it came out, I was like,
what is it?
Same with my thoughts.
Barry himself doesn't do that at all in this film, so you bet your ass I'm gonna do it.
Yep.
Resident Evil Retribution, the most necessary film in the universe. So this first underwater shot here, this is really the only shot I can say made me go, oh, that's a kind of neat 3D effect. Not that you can see that now. Here you go, throw on your 3D glasses.
Oh, I forgot how bad the 3D stuff was.
Anyway, the rest of the 3D
slow motion and that crud.
But it was mostly just slow motion crap done solely to show off the 3D. Which, coincidentally, is what this entire intro is. And yeah, it seems even more
pointless.
And it's boring. So let's speed it up, because it looks silly that way.
What the heck? Oh my god.
Ah, the money shot is still
Wait a minute. Hang on. I know. Alright, guys. This is something I forgot to mention, everyone. Back when I did the reaction to Resident Evil Afterlife, there was something I forgot to mention. Yeah, about the dual-wielding shotgun, another stupid scene from the last movie. Yeah, apparently Thomas Anderson does not know how heavy a shotgun is. And that's why many people who use a shotgun use it one hand. It's always supposed to be met one-handed. Otherwise, it'll be too heavy to lift. And once again, the money shot. As I said this before in the last one, I'll say it again. This will only jam the gun. So yeah, both those concepts from this one, last movie and this one are pretty much stupid. Continue.
First, same with that dual wielding shotguns. Those were the questions that were plaguing my mind.
Yep. This again.
I work for the Umbrella Corporation.
We're doing this again.
Yeah.
Seriously? We're really doing the Alice speech again. Do you realize of the 5 Resident Evil movies?
I'm sorry, I keep on pausing this, but I gotta address something here. Yeah, Aaron, you have already done this about, I don't know, many films already, for like 5 films now? Jeez, we learned to do a different take on a movie, William. There was a time I used to like Paul W. S. Anderson's movies. That was back when Mortal Kombat, you know? But, and this is stupid, you know, as we're about to see right now. So, yeah, let's get on with this.
Please, now only 2 haven't started with this, and it didn't happen in the first one, because that's the movie she's mostly recapping.
But hey, this is more effort than the Afterlife version, because I actually got Mila Jovovich to record it again. And this time, done less dramatically to give the lines less impact.
I was head of security at a secret high-tech facility called
Oh my, Retribution, man.
The virus escaped. A lot of people died. The trouble was, you didn't stay dead. My name is Alice.
Yep, I see the similarities.
At
See, there's a guy who knows how to do it better.
My dick boss is in charge of reviewing the 4 live-action Resident Evil movies. The
problem is, man.
Who was in that lab died, so it was accurate and said more dramatically originally. I never expected a recycled version of the speech to somehow be superior to anything. You know, the reason for this speech at the start of the second movie was kind of Alice's telling the world her story, but who the fuck is she telling this to now? Who's been recast?
Oh, dear.
One of the few like me who actually remembers all these stupid movies and pick up on that, you'll immediately be ticked off who's going to reappear in this movie.
You're all going to die down here.
So you remember Chris, what? Claire, and even Tamer, and how well they didn't do all
the Red Queen died in the first movie. He was fried. How did she appear? That doesn't make any sense.
Alice never even voices concern about them once. Anyway, the dumbass booby shuck gets played again in normal speed, and we get the biggest shock of the film.
Wait a minute. Am I missing something?
Alice sleeps in clothes. I thought for sure she'd sleep in the new.
Same.
Whoa, she's looking at her hair like it suddenly changed. Why? Because it's a misdirection. And now she's playing house with Carlos? What? How could this happen? Carlos
took a bunch of pieces.
I'm sorry to spoil the super shocking twist right now, but here it is. Whoa.
Ugh, Yikaba. Oh my goodness. No. I suppose I should expect at this point, but still, clones, when has that ever happened in the Resident Evil games? When? That was never a plot in the Resident Evil games. How is that even possible? Let me give you a fair point. What's really in the Resident Evil games, Anderson? Zombies. You fight to survive in a city or a mansion that has infectees, which is known as zombies, and you or plagas or one of the or both. You can't have clones that are not even part of the game. So why are you trying to put this in the film right here? Are you just trying to make a fan fiction out of this?
Again. I get the feeling this was a thought for the trailer more than
and another thing, Carlos died in the third movie.
Are dead, and then people will see them in the trailer and be like,
oh my gosh.
Yep. In this movie series, it's not even new within its own hack storylines. In fact, this little sequence ends the exact same way it did in the third and fourth movie. Oh man, is Alice dead? Nope, it was a clone. Wow. Oh man, is Alice dead for really reals this time? No, it was a clone again. Wow. Playing house gets interrupted when suddenly zombies! No shock there, but this does lead to the actual biggest shock of the film. Michelle Rodriguez playing a character who's nice!
Oh my gosh.
I never thought I'd see the day where she's playing a non-bitch.
Yeah.
She does have a dual role in this, and the other clone is a bitch, but still. Stupid, because, you know, the zombie chaos, that's kind of what's wrong with us. We didn't just jump out in front of you or anything, even. We were just standing here. Nice Rig as his car gets swiped by a garbage man. And since it was so nice to pick up Klonovich and her daughter, naturally she returns the favor by not even bothering to check if she's still alive, which she is. asshole. And when she dies, they play this off like this is Resident Evilception dream inside a dream style. And I know I blew up the Naked Alice counter, but I actually
like the robot. Thanks to my robot for blocking this.
With this being 36, I hope you enjoy the pointlessness I put myself through for these videos.
I'm sticking around for this.
The umbrella holding cell is a really tall room made of lights with the umbrella logo in the middle. It's convenient because it's not.
Yep.
Why did you turn against Umbrella? What?
Yeah.
That's kind of an old question, isn't it? And what's even a suitable answer?
Why did you turn against Umbrella?
The hours.
Why did you turn against? What kind of dumb question is that?
Hey, you creeps.
Why did you turn against Umbrella? Their security system
is going wrong. They're spraying amnesia gas.
Oh dear.
Yeah, that's pretty dumb. Fair enough.
Warning. Unauthorized computer access.
Oh dear.
Security system disabled. Central computer reboot in 2 minutes.
Well, here's some more brilliance from the Umbrella Corporation. If the security system goes off, not only do the cell doors open, but they spit out a nice skin-tight combat suit for you. Exactly an Alice's size, too.
Wow.
Security system disabled. Central computer reboot in 20 seconds.
Well, no hurry, is there? Might as well stay around here for a bit.
Another reason he's dumb.
The security system shutting down is so good, it shuts down all the people, because naturally everyone is controlled by the red mind orby spider thing. And of course they don't run into
This movie, the Umbrella Soldiers, are competent. One of the games, they are not.
The greatest minds at Umbrella, a long time to develop the mind control device. And even longer time to develop it again to make your eyes flash the Umbrella.
That's why I say Umbrella is pretty useless and incompetent.
So I'll continue to stand here. Wow, Alice, that's impressive. So guess what? Lasers again. Still can't let that stupidest part of the first movie go.
Ugh.
Of capturing Alice, if you're so willing to kill her now, to find out why she left Umbrella. A pressing question.
Yeah.
Sure. No. The security system.
Oh my goodness.
If they turn those lasers on, so there's absolutely no reason for those doors to open. Those doors open for no reason? No.
Would that be funny if that happened?
Well, since Alice got saved by magic this time,
she's going to
escape now, right?
Wait a minute.
No, not when there's more.
Is this a scene from the last movie? Yeah.
This is another clone test chamber thingy, like the clone Alice who died was in. And everyone, including the people, can just be activated? Do they all have mind spider control devices? Nope, and I don't think that'd work on zombies anyway. Plus, where were all these people? Just off screen, huh? Glad that's where Alice's field of vision ends, too. And does this scene look familiar?
It does.
It's the opening shot of Afterlife.
Yep.
So I guess that was from this Tokyo simulation running in this facility before? Nope, because it zoomed out to show the entire urban area. The simulation isn't quite that big. It just somehow managed to perfectly recreate a moment of real life that they could have no idea of how actually occurred. If they somehow did know how this happened, that's another really great use of your facility, isn't it?
Yeah.
Wow, that's incredibly stupid.
I know. That is pretty stupid.
That sums up the majority of this film.
Hilariosity of this, because it's so stupid.
Not open, and she'd be stuck And yep. Don't forget, she has no powers right now due to the power off needle from Wesker.
Yeah.
Yep. No powers. What a regular person.
This something also didn't make sense to me. In the last movie as well. Wesker took away her powers, and yet she is still able to beat these so-called zombies for, like, they were nothing. Really? 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 Really don't know how to do a movie anymore, do you, Anderson? No, I do this right. Movie right, do you, Anderson?
Next up, something that makes sense. Oh, wait, we're still watching Retribution, aren't we?
Yep.
In this room, desks rise if you enter it. Do they go down into another room, or did they used to get stuck working in the floor? And in either case, might be a little distracting trying to do your job and have your workstation rise up if someone enters a room.
My name is Ada Wong, operative for the Umbrella Corporation, one of Albert Wesker's top agents.
And I'll be the closest they'll get to getting a game character, right?
Only close.
She was a freelance operative in the games and only ever worked for Wesker before to get paid. And she's wearing a cocktail dress here to infiltrate an Umbrella facility in the middle of frozen Russia because she wore a similar dress in Resident Evil 4. And there's none of the playful and flirtatious banter or attitude between her and Leon, despite them usually being on the opposite sides, but we do get this.
Yep.
Did I say she was close to the game character? Because I meant not at all.
Yeah. Stupid.
See, it's just a screen.
We have to get you out of this facility.
So why do you want to help me?
We need you. The human race faces extinction.
Oh, fuck. No one should have
to. Yeah.
Besides, it just reminds us of how much you contradict.
Yep, pretty much.
You're in the prime umbrella testing facility.
Explain Tokyo.
It's a place in Japan.
Yeah.
Again, there. Oh, he couldn't actually go like that. I mean, who else is gonna do the position besides Wesker? I'm glad I have full access to the computers despite them regaining control.
Yep.
For a few city blocks. That's all.
It sure does.
Yep.
Resident Evil Afterlife. Yep.
Yeah.
The testing floor is 300 feet high. The ceiling black. It's usually night in there.
Oh, cool trick. Except they do a day simulation anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter.
Why build such a place?
Simple. The Umbrella Corporation derived its primary income from the sale of viral weaponry.
No, I'm pretty sure yep. that the majority of their sales came from the pharmaceutical and healthcare products they produced, and the majority of their viral weaponry sales came after they fucked up and caused an outbreak.
Yeah.
It's impossible to test in the real world. They recreated the center of New York, simulated an outbreak, showed it to the Russians, and sold them the virus. They simulated an outbreak in Moscow, sold it to the Americans, an outbreak in Tokyo.
Why did they have these specific areas recreated? Did the other nations into thinking it really happened there? Because, you know, it's pretty easy to check and see if it actually happened or not. Or did yeah. the nations really need to see a specific area infected to prove it would work there? And, you know, there's this other little minor detail of there was already a real viral outbreak happening.
I know, and after the second movie.
Raccoon City, we were told that. In fact, Alice even flat out said Umbrella tried to contain it.
The Umbrella Corporation thought they'd contained the infection. They were wrong. Raccoon City was just the beginning. Within weeks, the T-virus had consumed the United States. Within months, the world.
So one, they would need to show simulations right. To prove it would work. And two, why was Umbrella even bothering to try and contain it if they're also trying to spread it all over the world again? Because that's the implication here, that it happened because of Umbrella's manufactured viral arms race.
The virus didn't just wipe out human life. Lakes and rivers dried up, forests became deserts, and whole continents were reduced to nothing more than barren wastelands. Slowly but surely.
How did they continue to screw up their own continuity?
So when was this viral arms race happening? During the zombie apocalypse?
Yeah.
For one fucking second to remember your own damn storyline, Resident Evil?
Yeah.
This goes to shoot the windows out to escape and actually has to be told, hey, actually look out them. It's water out there. We are underwater.
Right.
Don't do that or we will die.
Yeah, how stupid is she?
Apparently, Elsa's brains were shut off along with her powers.
Yep.
But luckily, there's a ground entrance to this place, the Rebel Base on Hoth, which means
nice.
Yes, Ada just got excited and ran ahead because, you know, why bother sending the rescue team in all at once? And, of course, who else would be part of Wesker's team than people who usually worked against him in the games? Leon Kennedy and Barry? Oh, Barry! And, you know, Leon's looking pretty damn good for a dead man. Yes, according to the Raccoon City Times, Leon is dead. This is promotional material we gave out during Resident Evil Apocalypse. The article from Jill's Wall from that movie. And not only does it say that he is dead, but that he was Jill's partner. They speak one single word to each other in this film, but hey,
right.
This wouldn't be the Resident Evil film series if we remembered a damn thing we set up. Speaking of this paper, it also tells me that Alice's real name is Yanis Prospero, and she apparently had family looking for her. Family she has never once mentioned
or right.
Concerned for. But why should Alice be concerned about anyone? Everyone should be concerned about Alice and saving Alice, because that's all we do this film. So
I know.
Same.
You were almost in a sandwich. Barry! Alright, let's get to the end of the video. Support you, man.
It's Resident Evil time again. Guess that'd be why I'm dressed this way.
Yep.
Wait a second. Apocalypse. Newspaper. Thanks.
All right, everyone. That was part one, and since I'm running out of the time, I'll be doing part two. On the next episode, everyone. Tomorrow, anyway. Hang on. I have to take a call. Peace out, comrades. Why is it calling? When I mean, I thought they would take my calm by now. When I'm in this simulation. Hello, Commander. Commander, we've been looking for you. Commander Grizzly, are you there? I'm here, Joe. goes, When you arrive at the station for our ship retrofits, you weren't on board, sir. We've been wondering what happened to you. It's worse than you think, Joe. The AZTEK Corp, during our voyage, right, during when we were stuck in the cloud, the AZTEK Corporation captured me already. So, what? So the commander who was on board, he was an Joe, the one who was on board impersonating as me, he's an imposter. His real name is Sir Patrick O'Liam. He's the head of Zodiac Arts. Are you talking about one of the greatest corporations out there? Yes. I need you to contact Admiral Nesp. Plus, this is the only time I can be able to make my comm call for you right now, I'm afraid. Why? No, I don't want anybody coming after the Federation right now. The only way to rescue me right now, you're on your own right now, okay? For now. Contact the Admiral Nesp. Tell her it's my wish that the one who will be leading the SSG Grizzly would be Jack Panda. For now, he'll be the commander of the ship. For now, until the AZTEK Corporation defeated. Once they're defeated, I can be able to be free from here, from my prison. The time. For now, you already know what to do, Joe. Understood, Commander. Commander, please hang in there, okay? We'll do everything. I promise. We'll bring him down and we will find a way to rescue you. I appreciate that. Commander Grizzly out.